my name is Martha Zameda, a wireless application engineer. As we all know, carrier aggregation is one of the most important features of LTE-Advanced, allowing wider transmission bandwidth corresponding to higher data rates. This new technology introduces new requirements and new challenges to the RF conformance testing of base stations and user equipment. In this video, I'll explain the new RF requirements and measurement challenges pertaining to base station transmitters and how Agilent can help you address these challenges using X-series signal analyzers with the LTE Advanced measurement application. In this setup, I have the Agilent MXG vector signal generator emulating an LTE Advanced base station that's transmitting both contiguous and non-contiguous carrier aggregation signal. The RF output is connected to the RF input of the Agilent X-series signal analyzer that's running the embedded LTE Advanced measurement application. Here's a list of base station transmitter tests as defined in Section 6 of 3GPP TS36.141 specification, as well as the list of corresponding measurements on Agilent X-Series LTE Advanced measurement application, covering all the tests. For those of you that have experience with LTE, these should look very familiar. There are new tests introduced for LTE Advanced as a result of carrier aggregation, highlighted here in green. Other tests, highlighted in dark blue, are existing LTE tests, but the test parameters have been modified to support carrier aggregation. The time alignment error test was initially defined for MIMO and transmit diversity in LTE release 8 and 9. However, new requirements have been added to LTE Advanced for carrier aggregation. The most extensive changes were introduced in release 11, where new RF requirements were added for non-contiguous carrier aggregation to take into account additional emissions within the subblock gap, called cumulative ACLR and cumulative spectrum emission mask. Here is an example of non-contiguous carrier aggregation with a subblock gap. Subblock gap is the frequency gap between two consecutive subblocks within an RF bandwidth. The spectrum and the subblock gap can be occupied by other service providers, perhaps deploying other technologies such as wideband CDMA. So the new base station RF requirements within the subblock gap are based on coexistence for uncoordinated operation. The cumulative ACLR and the cumulative spectrum emission mask measurements are defined within the subblock gap. And the challenge with these new requirements is that you have to take into account contributions from carriers on both sides of the subblock gap. I'm going to show you how this works with two quick demonstrations. The first demonstration will include two non-contiguously allocated component carriers with a subblock gap of 18 megahertz to show the new cumulative ACLR and cumulative spectrum emission mask requirements. The second demonstration will take you through measurements for five contiguously allocated component carriers. In the case of ACLR, depending on the width of the subblock gap, the leakage from carriers from both sides of the gap can overlap. This is what cumulative ACLR measures. As you can see here, if the gap is greater than 5 megahertz and less than 20 megahertz, either one or both of the inner offsets will be cumulative. For our demonstration, we will use 18 megahertz subblock gap, so the second offset will be cumulative. Similarly, for spectrum emission mask, the mask within a subblock gap is calculated as the cumulative sum of contributions from the upper and the lower subblocks, except for offsets greater than or equals to 10.5 megahertz, where the mask is non-cumulative per the definition of 3GPP. So let's look at our first demonstration. The signal generated by the MXG vector signal generator is two 10 megahertz wide component carriers with a subblock gap of 18 megahertz. On the X-series signal analyzer, under the mode key, there are LTE Advanced FDD and TDD modes, but we'll focus on FDD for this demonstration. Both uplink and downlink tests are available, but I'll leave it on downlink for base station transmitter testing. Let's now configure the component carriers. We do that under the frequency key. There are two component carriers, but I can choose up to the maximum of five. So it's ready for your future scenarios that will exceed two component carriers. For this demonstration, the carrier allocation is set to non-contiguous. Now let's configure each individual component carrier in terms of frequency offsets and bandwidth. On the screen, you can quickly see the two 10 megahertz component carriers with a subblock gap of 18 megahertz. We are now ready to measure the transmitter measurements, and you can see all available measurements from channel power to occupied bandwidth to all of the unwanted emission measurements and modulation analysis. Let's look at cumulative ACLR measurement first. I'll select ACP. Since this is non-contiguous carrier aggregation, you can define both the inner and outer offset parameters and limits under the measure setup key. By default, the display is showing outer offsets, but if I go to the view display key, I can choose to show outer and inner, and it will show me both offsets. Since the subblock gap is 18 megahertz, I have set the inner offset B to be cumulative, and you can see that listed on the bottom of the table. Similarly, for spectrum emission mask, you can go to measure spectrum emission mask and choose to configure and view either the inner or outer offsets. According to the standard, inner offsets less than or equals to 10.5 megahertz use cumulative mask, and you can see that in the display with a different color for the cumulative mask. Let's now move to our second demonstration for contiguous carrier aggregation measurement. We're using 5 contiguously allocated component carriers, each 20 megahertz wide. The ACP and SCM measurements are similar to multi-carrier transmissions, where the limits are defined relative to the carriers on the edges of the RF bandwidth. For transmitted signal quality measurement, the RF conformance requirement is to measure the EVM and frequency error of the individual component carriers. Under Measure, select Modulation Analysis. I've set up the windows to show the constellation diagram of all 5 component carriers. You can change each of the windows to show whatever you choose for any of the component carriers. All the powerful demodulation capabilities and the color codings in our LTE application is available for each individual component carrier. You can also measure the time alignment between each component carrier by using either an external trigger or the internal frame trigger. For manufacturing, where speed is critical, the conformance EVM measurement returns speed-optimized numeric demodulated results for each of the component carriers. Here you can see the results for component carrier 0, component carrier 1, and more. This completes our tour of the LTE-Advanced measurement application for performing base station transmitter RF conformance testing as defined by 3GPP. The X-Series LTE-Advanced measurement application provides the most comprehensive transmitter conformance testing in the industry. For non-contiguous carrier aggregation, I showed you the RF requirements, particularly cumulative ACLR and cumulative spectrum emission mask. For contiguously allocated component carriers, you saw a quick demo of ACLR and spectrum emission mask. In addition, you looked at the demodulation measurements where the demodulated results of all component carriers being displayed side by side. For more information and free 30-day trial license, please visit the links on the screen. Thanks for watching.